Hello, YouTube. My name is Nero, and welcome back to the Madden NFL 16 playthrough, where the 7-3 Atlanta Falcons will be on the road against the 4-6 Seattle Seahawks. Ladies and gentlemen, it's going to be Joe Nero versus Russell Wilson. Although, for whatever reason, 4-6, that's not very good for the Seahawks. Looking, of course, at our injuries here. Now let's go down to the Seattle Seahawks, see what's going on with them. All right, so Isaiah Crowell, the Cleveland Brown in real life, is going to be injured for them. I wonder if he's actually supposed to be their starter? Like, it's a little bit odd that that we see someone like Seattle having a losing record like that. So let's go ahead and check out what's going on with their team. I wonder how they've changed over the past, you know, 6 seasons. So they still have Richard Sherman. They still have Russell Wilson. Okay, fair enough. So Russell's there, 99 overall, with Brock Osweiler as his backup. Okay. Isaiah Crowell is supposed to be their starter. They have no run game, man. They got this guy who is, you know, of course, made by the game with a 73 overall as their starter. That's pretty rough, all right? So their fullback's not bad. Maybe they should put him as a starter. Then Jermaine Kearse, Mohamed Sanu, and then Zach Mosley, Charles Johnson. So the receivers aren't terrible, and of course they have one of the best quarterbacks in the game, and they don't really have, they got Niles Paul. That's who they got. They need to start Niles. Suddenly things will be fine. Of course, Niles Paul was fantastic for me back in Washington. But yeah, me versus Russell Wilson. Me and him are actually very close together on the legacy leaderboard here in Madden 16, so if I can come away with a win, it probably won't affect anything, but still, it's always good to try and take on Russell Wilson because, of course, he's a very good player, very good quarterback, and usually the Seahawks are a pretty good team. I imagine their defense is going to be pretty scary, and, of course, we are known for our offense, so I have to wonder how that's going to turn out. But, ladies and gentlemen, without further ado, I will see you guys when the game actually launches.
Hello, everybody. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. Two teams will need their quarterbacks to step up and lead their offenses on the gridiron today. It's the Seahawks going up against the Falcons.
These stats are not even about to be close. Oh my goodness. Okay, so their offense is struggling mightily, it would appear, given their starting running back is injured and their backup's like a 70-something overall. And then Russell Wilson, who you think is like the key to their offense, he's going to be the guy, you know, if they're going to have success, it's going to be because of him. He is mightily struggling. What was that, 11 touchdowns, like 7 interceptions? I hope I have that right. I just saw it. My memory's not that great. I just woke up, ladies and gentlemen. It's very early. But still, that is pretty bad. I mean, 11 touchdowns over the course of the entire season. I threw for 7 last week alone. But of course, that was the best game that I have ever had, ever. Not only in Madden 16, but that's probably the best game I've ever had in Madden as a whole. It was pretty insane. If you guys didn't catch the last episode, I would highly recommend it. Usually I put annotations on these videos. For whatever reason, while using Firefox, I can't add annotations to YouTube videos. I have no idea why. I think I have to do everything on like Internet Explorer or something like that, because how I do it is I do all my nearest cinema stuff on Google Chrome, whereas everything for like nearest Let's Plays is on Firefox. That way I can have them both open at the same time, so I have to sign in and out, which is nice. But for whatever reason, I can't add annotations. Okay, so they get a field goal to start, and we get the ball here on the 16-yard line. Not too shabby. Let's start things off here with a shotgun run, because those have been working for us. We'll go for the halfback. The zone looked good, but we're going to go for the quick base here. And we're going to see if the old Legion of Boom is going to try and shut us down or not, or what's going to be going on. All right, so far, so good. So far, so good. Let's do a hurry-up. We're going to mess with them now. We're going to catch him with their pants down with a drive trail. Going to get Cobb coming across. If not, perhaps Charles. Maybe even Bryant or my running back. I like a lot of my options on this play here. And we waited last second, and then we dumped it off. They had a nice zone defense there, but I saw it, man. He's got to wait. You got to be patient. You've got to be patient. Oh, QB power. Don't you tempt me. All right, we're going to look for play action deep outs here. On the off chance, oh, God, they're going to go cover 3. All right, if they're going cover 3, then deep outs is not going to work. But Verts here may. We'll have to see. And there he is. I will pick apart your zone defense all day and night, Seattle. You're going to have to do something a little bit different. You're going to have to do something a little bit different. Let's. Should we go back to the run? Go for a, like a straight-up draw? Now they're bumping people down again. How many times I got to teach you this lesson, Seattle? How many times I got to teach you this lesson? And all right, so they're actually covering it this time, but my running back is pretty much wide open. So there we go. Nice short pass. Take that. All right, we'll let them rest. We'll swap out formations here. And what should we run? I want another. Yeah, let's go for an inside zone here. Is this the same formation? No, it ain't. Okay. Wait, or is it? I may be in the same formation. Not regardless, we swapped out some receivers and stuff like that. I figured Bryant would be out, or Barnett would be out, but he isn't. Two carries for 11 yards. Things are going good. I feel like I have like a college offense with this team, you know, play action, deep shot. They're still in cover three. They are insistent on cover three, man. I don't think any of these plays are particularly fantastic against the cover three, honestly. So we're going to go for the 0-1 trap. All right, now they're faking this out. Now they're in the cover two. All right, now they're back in cover three. Oh my gosh, you guys. How many times I got to teach this lesson? How many times? And I'm not like, oh! First and foremost, what I guess my running back got bumped into. I threw that like off of instinct. Like, oh yeah, he'll be open by this point. He wasn't. Holy crap. I guess he got bumped into. They must have thought he was actually running or something like that. We're going to look for Nicholas here. Maybe Cobb deep, but primarily Nicholas. And there's Nicky. I love that route. It's like you do a corner, then you cut back in for a post. It's a good route. I forget what you call it, though. There's a name for it, obviously. But let's just go for a halfback toss. You know, I have a feeling. Actually, maybe not. They got Richard Sherman over there. You know what? Never mind. They look like they're honestly ready to just end his whole career if I run that toss. So we're going to go for a play fake and look for somebody in the end zone, assuming they're blitzing. And they are, but we're going to toss over anyway. What a throw against my third string tight end versus Richard Sherman. I didn't think that was even going to be completed, let alone be a touchdown. I think his name's Cambrill Mason. I've never scored off a play like that. I don't think that was a touchdown. Did he even get I don't think he got any of his... Yeah. Going back and looking at that, I don't think he got his feet in at all. No. No, there's no way. Wait, unless there's a sort of rule with a pylon, maybe. Yeah, I don't think that's going to count. Maybe he even did. You're wearing Roddy White's old number, of course. Both feet, see if they're in bounds, and don't forget... It stands? I guess I don't know the rules with the pylon. But whatever. It counts. Touchdown, Joe Nero. And we get the ball back here on the 45-yard line. Ooh, we're going four wide, are we? Well, technically three wide with our tight end out. I like these run plays out of the shotgun. They typically work. I don't know. I feel like we're just like a college offense. You know, always in the shotgun, always airing it out, spreading the field. Doing all kinds of cool stuff like that. And no. I didn't realize the first quarter was actually rapidly coming to an end like that. All right. Deep corner. I don't like that play. I like the routes on deep corner, but it's so far away. Look how far out the wide receivers are. Usually that means, I don't know, there's not as open in my experience. All right. The post is going to be there. Oh, he got bumped into. And it's... Whoa, wait. I thought that was intercepted. I could have sworn that was intercepted by... What? What? There's no way. Where's the replay? One, how'd he catch that? Two, how was that a touchdown? Okay, so we saw the run after the thing. Hold on here. I think the game glitched out here because this makes literally no sense. Okay, so we're gonna zoom in on here on the Julio Jones. You know, he's sitting there. He's looking all good. Now he's going to start running. Then he's going to come in for the post. I anticipated the post being crispy clean. And therefore, typically, right when he makes this break, that's when he's going to be open, right? And I'm like, okay. But no, he bumps in to Bryant there. And I'm like, oh, no. He's bumped into. Look at the ball. Ball's in the air. And he is not in a good position to catch this ball. So I'm like, oh, gosh. It's going right to Richard Sherman. Right here, I'm like, yep, that's an interception. I could have sworn it was going to be an interception. Look at it. It looks like it's going to Sherman. But look at him. Yoink. Richard's like, wait, what? I didn't get it? And he's like, no, sir. And he just runs past Cam. This is silly. Madden is silly. This is a silly game. Okay, maybe we shouldn't go out of the shotgun here. What do you guys think? We'll go for a full-on draw. You guys hear the break in the audio right there? Like, the Falcons are ready to take on ball. Oh, man. Sometimes you can hear, like, a break in the commentator's audio. zone in so many. All right, here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Is this the formation with my play action deep? No. Oh, it is. These guys love cover three, but now I think they're back in cover two. I think they're in cover two now. We'll have to see. Oh, gosh. They are. And he's open. And he catches it. Good catch. I honestly thought that that number 33, whoever it was that was catching him, but covering him there, I really thought that guy, he was going to be able to burn him. Because I figured like that was like some crappy, you know, third string corner that's like got like a really low overall. But he held on to him. Not held on to him, but like, he's, you know, he stuck to him is what I meant to say. So, not bad. Not bad. Gotta give him credit where credit is due. That was some solid defense, what that was. Let's go for a quick slant. Although, they've been really running, like, hard zones. Yeah, quick slant ain't gonna work. They're really running hard zones this whole whole quarter here, or whole half. So, let's go ahead and hobble this out. And wide open. There's Nicholas coming underneath. Now, it should be like a third and two. It's their first third down. Inside cross. Perfect. Crossing routes are perfect for third downs. I mean, look at this. Look at, oh, gosh. Oh! Oh, what a monster. I don't know who this Travis guy is, but I figured that'd be easy. Oh, no. Oh, no. He was on him. Well, I guess we're after the punt. I mean, we're on the 46-yard line here. Can't score on every drive, right, guys? Is he actually going to go out of the corner? Oh, well done, sir. Well done. You got to get in the old coffin corner. Who remembers the old Madden games where you could actually, like, control training camp? And by, like, doing well in the training camp, you'd have, like, a boost to your guys' overall in your franchise. So you'd, like, do the punter thing where you had to do the coffin corner, trying to up the overall of your punter and having to do the running back drills and the quarterback drills and all that stuff. Madden used to be so good, right? Now it's just such a stripped-down version of what it used to be. Okay, so they did not score again. And we get the ball here on our own 39-yard line. Not bad. Shall take it. That number 33 is over there in Bryant again. I wonder how good he actually is. Oh, there we go. Not bad. Not bad. Not too, hurry up. I think a slants may work. Ah, they're bumping up again. No, they're going to be like a drop back zone. So I think maybe slants might be here. And it is. Slants is definitely there. Let's get down there to Alden, the rookie, who caught that amazing touchdown in the bonus episode. I'm still mad that touchdown that he caught did not count because the game froze. And we're just going to have a run play here right before the two-minute warning. Oh, 67 there, whiffed his block. Terrible. All right, so we're here on the 45-yard line. Can Joe Nero get in the end? Wait. If that's number 67, I'm going to cry. Okay. I was going to say, 67 completely just whiffed his block and like didn't do anything. All right, so what we got here, boys? We're going to go for a bench. The reason why is I want to do a hurry-up because this is the formation that has mesh and halfback wheel and all that great stuff in it. So we're going to try and get a play in this formation off. I'm just going to dump off my running back. Oh, look at him breaking tackles and going forward. Now we're going to do a hurry-up. And now we're in the good formation, boys. Now we're in the good formation. We can do a mesh, but I want a halfback wheel. Here we go. If they stay in the proper cover, too, it's over, man. It's over. Oh, no. Oh, there he is. There he is! What is with this defense? Jeff Fisher's like, I should have stayed in Tennessee. Touchdown here in the second quarter gives them a nice lead with the intermission looming, Phil. Oh, man. That was kind of a silly jump there, but regardless, whatever. I'll take it. Okay. We gotta get back into this here because we're on the 7-yard line. We've started from further. I don't think we ever scored from further, but we started from further. We're gonna drive down and score here. Although it took me a while to decide my play there. I think we'll be able to get it off though. Yeah, we're all right. Stay in that cover two for me, guys. And of course they don't. Boris gonna dump this down to my running back on the. Oh no! Richard Sherman forced the fumble and recovered it. I was really hoping that he was just gonna like make a mockery of Richard Sherman, right? Just because he's like known as like the best corner in the league. I was hoping he was just gonna give him the old Jamal Lewis truck stick, right, and just go through him and get the first. But instead he fumbles, then Richard gets it, then I assume they're gonna get a touchdown, and they do. Okay, fair enough. Fair enough. That's two fumbles. Martavis Bryant lost one a couple weeks ago. I forget exactly when it was. And then now Barnett lost one. Well, we're just going to, I think, run out the half here. It seems to make sense to me. Just keep running to the left here. A nice zone play. All right. All right. Look at you guys coming up and actually stopping us. So we're going to try a pass play here just to get the first. I don't even know why we're doing it because this is going to end off the half, but whatever. And dump it off. And there goes Charles. I was hoping to get a timeout there, but no such luck. I'll take it. Get a 9-yard pass off to my man Charles there before the end of the first half. We are inching ever closer towards 4,000 yards on the season. We may actually be there. I'm not even sure. All right, so killing them in that. All right, so yeah, they're just not doing good as a whole. They have a pretty good time of possession, but their yards per play is like abysmal. Like, I'm averaging a first down every play. And that's, of course, being inflated by the fact that I have two very long touchdown passes. But still, you guys, oh, they want me to run a mesh. Well, I've never ran this play before. I hope I do it all right. And there's Jones versus, oh, I was hoping he was going to break the Richard Sherman tackle. I was hoping. 4,000 passing yards on the season, boys. There we go. Oh, and we're going to hurry up into a halfback wheel. I love this formation. It's seriously the best formation in Madden. It's like got to be. All right, so they're definitely going to be covering the post. So I think Bryant is going to be my go-to guy here. You know what? I'm not liking Bryant. I wasn't even really liking Chuck. Was Bryant open on that corner? Because I stopped looking at him after a while. So the post wasn't open. Initially, Bryant wasn't open. And then my tight end coming across wasn't open. Maybe there was somebody, but I look at three targets there, and like they had that down, man. You know what? No. We're going to run, try and make it a short first down, or short third down, rather. All right, we got a flag. It's probably holding, because I didn't see a face mask. Usually, I'm pretty quick at calling out face mask. Yeah. It's usually really apparent when there's a face mask, but, you know, other times it's not as apparent when there's holding. All right, let's try that slot fade shot. This worked earlier to Charles. He's got like that out turn into a post route. Then you got Jones running potentially ridiculously deep. I was going to pull it up. I was putting it up. I pressed the button, but I got hit. We have taken a sack. I was going to put up that prayer. We can try a play action deep outs here, see if they're in cover two, but they've been in cover three like the whole game, so I doubt. Okay, they're not. Okay, hold on. Let's do a couple fake audibles here. My fake audibles aren't working, guys. All right, so let's do a real audible and then go back to the original play, see if we can get them to be in the cover two. They're still in cover three, I think. Oh, he's wide open right now. He's running, get across the first, bud. Martavis. How does that work? Let's get a run play here. Let's get a shotgun run play. Keep them honest. I think one of the reasons those deep pass plays work is because they actually, you know, they're... How do I run against this? They have so many people in the box. How many times I got to teach you this lesson, Seattle? How many times I got to teach you this lesson? And... going up the hoop. Oh, come on, man. How did you not just tuck that right after you caught it? Must have been a big hit. Let's go for a drive trail then, I guess. One of these days, I'm going to get punished for that. That's like two dropped interceptions this game, whereas other times they never drop interceptions. I'll try play action deep outs again, I guess, because it makes sense, I guess, to go play action deep outs. It's worked twice so far today, hasn't it? And here we go. And they're actually covering. They're covering like everything really well. Like, they were covering the post, and then if the post isn't there, the out routes aren't going to be there. And the in route wasn't there either. We're just going to have to go max cover punt. Hold on, wait 9 seconds so we can get our bonus XP for sustaining a drive. Are they going to do it? Wait, no, because I guess the clock stops. It probably wouldn't count. Lucky bounce. Oh, we almost had a really lucky bounce right there. That was within like a couple yards. was within a couple of yards of being a perfect punt. And we get the ball back again. So, yeah, our defense is, like, just making a mockery of their offense. But their defense, really, we're not having a lot of success. We put up three touchdowns, but two of them are, like, long. I'll even go as far as to call them, you know, fluke plays. I think they were flukes. But aside from that, man, their defense has been pretty rock solid on most of the things I'm trying to do to them. I mean, I've thrown more incompletions, you know, this game they had, like, the past 2 weeks combined. Let's go for a zone week. I like this run play a lot. That safety crashed hard. We got 8 carries for 30 yards, so we're not doing brilliantly in that respect. We can try his slants, although I just don't see it being there. But then again, it was there earlier, so we'll have to see. Okay, it's... Oh! When you don't have time for slants, such as poor blocking. I know they blitz, but still, holy goodness, man. Holy goodness. Yeah, I'm not liking this. This is the first time in, like, 3 or 4 weeks, maybe, that we've really been stalling. Maybe 3 weeks. Like, usually we don't stall this badly. Like, usually if I stall, then we start losing because our defense, you know, lets them have a bunch of points. I think we're kind of fortunate in that the Seahawks have a very bad offense and a really good defense. So the fact that we got a lead on that good defense early on is giving our defense, you know, a lot of leeway with their awful offense. But, you know, I would like, of course, actually get in the end zone here. Let's get the score in here. Let's get the score in here. Let's see what we can do here. We got Martavis Bryant, deep corner. If not, we're looking for Barnett. And we're looking Barnett. Oh, what kind of a throw is that? What kind of a throw is that? I don't know what to do, man. I'm stalling here. Halfback wheel. There we go. There we go. Hey, Cobb, you want to catch another touchdown off of this? That'd be fantastic. And Cobb's wide open. And, of course, Hooning on the offense. I hate it. I hate it. I hate this game. What's that? You had a spark in your otherwise dismal past couple of drives? Let's go ahead and hold. As if that holding was even, like, relevant to the play, you know? And wide open throw on the run. Very nice. Very nice. There's 300. I mean, look at last week. That was stupid. Last week was the best game I've ever had. Ever. Oh, my gosh. I'll just go inside cross, I think. Now let's see what we got. And wide open. I mean, he's open underneath, but he's not going to do. Oh, look at him go. Oh, look at him go. Fighting Richard Sherman. I'll take that. I will take that. Second and one. Inside zone, especially because we got 2 tight ends here. This looks perfect. This looks perfect. And here he goes. Yep, easy first. Are we going to hold? No, we're not going to hold that time. Let's go hitch corners. I have my 2 tight ends running corner routes. This couldn't possibly go wrong. And I'm just going to fire it. Oh, my. If that would have been intercepted, I would have been ridiculously mad. I hate nothing more than tipped interceptions. That would have been a really cool catch. Would have been a pretty cool interception, but still, like, it would have been annoying. Let's go play action flood. See what we've got here. All right, looks like they may be blitzing, actually, so I'm going to have to dump this off really quickly. And they are, and they're leaving my fullback open. And holding, probably. Is there anything more annoying than holding? It's like a completely, it's just a little bit of RNG just randomly screws you. We fun, engaging. The defense accepts the penalty. Can we just play the game, Madden? Can you stop just throwing out random penalties? Let's go play action flood. Same play. I ain't afraid. Work for real, work again. And they're actually blitzing me really hard, but leaving my fullback wide. Break that tackle, bud. Break it. Lower your shoulder. You know how much bigger you are than him? Yeah, they have a 7th-ranked defense. I assume they'd have a good defense. Seattle always has a good defense. Play action deep outs. Let's get it. Let's get it. 3rd and 11. Oh, we got Harper there, too. Although, they're in cover three. You know, they're in cover three. We're just going to go for the verts instead. It'll probably work better. And... oh, no! My running back was really open, but I was waiting. I kept hoping that Harper, my wide receiver, would have been open. No such luck. I kept waiting for him to make that break. Then by the time, you know, I decided to give up on waiting for that route to develop, I basically got hit. Couldn't get my running back in time. I'm tired of this stalling, because you guys realize if they were to go ahead and if they drive down and score a touchdown here and then 2-point conversion, they tie. We need to score. We need to make this a 2-score game. All right, defense. I believe. I shouldn't have believed. Go for a bench, because you guys know the drill. This is our formation. We're going to use this formation. We got to drive down and score. Last second. And the out route's actually there. I never actually throw the out route. Oh, look at Randall go. Look at Randall go. No way. Oh, he got caught. Okay. Catch of the day. Randall, you're a monster. Have I mentioned that lately? That you're just snaps. We're in field goal range. That one play has put us in position to just straight up win. We can just kind of run it out and get a field goal last second and win. Thanks to Mr. Randall Cobb taking an out route down the field. We're getting so lucky off of like straight up fluke plays. Like these plays are just freaking, they're flukes. Aside from that, their defense has been really bend but don't break. I mean, they broke a couple times off of very lucky plays, but for the most part, they're just playing a really good, like, solid defense. But it doesn't matter anymore. And now we can just run it out and go for a field goal last second. But we might honestly just go for the touchdown. Because how many times have we, like, put our team in position for an easy score, easy field goal, then either they don't kick the field goal or somehow they miss it, or something stupid happens. That's their third time out. I don't even know what to do here, guys. Part of me wants to try and score. Another part of me is like, do I risk an interception? I don't know. I think we should just keep on running. We got to put our faith in the game. We just hope Madden doesn't screw us, which has happened multiple times in this series. And holding, here we go. Let it begin. Let's do a bunch of holdings and stupid penalties and drop them back out of field goal range. That sound good? Seriously, though, is anybody keeping track? Is that like the fifth holding this game? Like, now we're on the 34. Like, let's go inside cross. We got Harper coming across. That usually works so well. And no blitzing. And then there's Harper. Don't fumble, man. Don't fumble. Hold on to that ball. All right, good job. Good job. Now we're on the 28. Now we do a hurry up into the stick and nod. The stick and nod with Bryant coming across. That sounds perfect. And we're just going to hit Bryant. Don't you fumble. All right. I'm calling a timeout now. Because if not, I think we've had it before where I'm like, okay, we'll call a field goal unit. Then they don't kick it in time or something stupid like that. So here we go. Okay, since it's actually letting us see it, I don't think we've ever actually missed if we can actually watch the field goal. So I think we're good. There it is. They have 15 seconds, though. You know what? That was a big mistake on my part. Instead of calling a timeout, I should have waited. I should have waited a very long time. But what I called the timeout because I was worried they were going to put me in this screen right here and give me no control. Whereas it would have been better if I could have actually waited, you know, until like 1 second left, then called the timeout, then kicked the field goal. This is kind of scary, actually, because they may score now. Let's see. So they got 9 seconds. 5-yard pass. They got 3 seconds. No, they have no timeout. That's the end of the game. Yeah, they didn't have it. Oh, I guess they did have time for another play, but it resulted in Russell Wilson running. Well, ladies and gentlemen, a bit of a nail biter, I suppose. A little bit of a close one there at the end. Wasn't quite sure what was going to happen. I was like, oh boy, here we go. It's all tied up. Like 1 minute left. We got to go like 80 something yards Let me throw this out route real quick. Oh, okay, here we go. And then Russell, he just goes all the way down. Randall Cobb just decides, you know what? We're just going to take this out route all the way down. And, yeah. Kind of silly, honestly. All right, let's get past this screen. Let's get past it all because, I mean, I have, like, PTSD from that time Madden froze up on me after having a really good game and making me basically replay the game and stuff. I don't like that. Let's just get out of here. All right, wow, Russell had a good game. Russell had a better completion percentage than me, and I usually have a really high completion percentage. So I went 22 of 30 for 385 and 3 touchdowns. Russell went 31 of 40 for 281, 2 touchdowns and a pick. So he's throwing a lot. He's up off to a lot of short passes and stuff. Okay. Running wise, Marcus Barnett, 12 for 43. And of course, that lost fumble. And Christian Michael at 1 for 7. I didn't run whatsoever. Oh, gosh. Look at this. Okay. So we got Martavis Bryant, 5 for 111. We have Marcus Barnett, 3 for 14. Julio Jones, 3 for 75. And that awesome touchdown. Randall Cobb, 3 for 107 in a touchdown. Two of those catches were just nice, very long, amazing plays. Fernando Alden, 2 for 18, 2 for 32 for Troy Nicholas, 1 for 6, Adrian Harper, James Devlin, my fullback, 1 for 9, Orson Charles, 1 for 9, and Cameron Mason, 1 for 4, and of course, that touchdown. Very nice overall week, just keeping the momentum. What's that? Is that 5 straight games? We started off, yeah, I think so, because didn't we start off 3-0, then we lost 3 straight, and now we've won 5 straight. Like, it's a feast or famine, it seems like, here at the Atlanta Falcons. But ladies and gentlemen, we're continuing the hot streak. I hope you guys all enjoyed the video. Please drop me a rating. Hope you guys all have a wonderful day.